I tiptoe around on the periphery of Christmas preparations and traditions that were once mine, previously my mother's, and her mother's before that, only for Sigrid and Magnus to adopt them with an exaggerated sense of authority. It's as if they've been ready and waiting all this time, and have finally been given the green light to forge ahead, to execute their coup. I can't be the memorable version of myself that I plan to be. I feel irritated and restless about being undermined in this way, made invisible, prevented from bringing anything to the table. "Now you're just being ungrateful," Gustav Sent seems to say, as I lie there with my head in his lap, complaining. "You should be glad they came at all." The ambivalence is suffocating. And on the morning of Christmas Eve, I make my way into the living room and see that the tree has been decorated, with angels and tinsel and tasty treats hanging in all the wrong places. Aslak making porridge and Magnus whittling sticks for crisscrossing at the bottom of the mutton dish, while Mia lays the table, I make my way to the cart shed outside and dig out Gustav's old bamboo snowshoes. I perch myself on the chopping block. It's flecked with dried chicken blood and chainsaw oil. I have to catch my breath before strapping on the snowshoes, rest my index finger on a stretched hole in the leather strap for a moment. Picture Gustav's back, his mustard yellow anorak and green backpack, ahead of me all the way up to the mountain pasture. I pull the strap tight, buckling it, using the innermost hole. I make my way up the snowy path behind the barn, into the forest, up the mountainside, slow and steady. I'm not as ill as everyone's expressions and gestures would suggest.